Hey, I know I'm a fine artist painter, but it's just fun to do this. So stick around to the end and I'll show you how I use this same process in some of the crafty things I made for Halloween. I'm starting with a canvas that has toned with various shades of grays, and now I'm adding some blue. This is ultramarine blue and some purple mixed together for the sky. And I'm gonna make sure I get the top, the sides, and as I come down, I'm going to get lighter and lighter. I'm adding some lighter colors to the paint at this point. A little white. This paint is very transparent, and so when you add some white to it, it makes it opaque. And again, I'm just going over the top and the sides to make sure that they all look well. This is probably not going to be framed, so I want it to look good on all four sides. So again, I'm just going to pick up some more light color and add that in there. It's going to get lighter as it comes down to the horizon. That's how you create depth in any painting, is particularly a landscape. If you start at a dark color at the top and come down and get lighter as you go, it will give perspective. Okay, so I'm just going to add some more blue, various shades, and you're going to see that I'm just going to keep on blending them together. I love all the colors that are in there, but I don't want them to be stripes. I want them to have kind of just blend right into each other. And if you keep going over where they where it appears to be a stripe, if you'll cover over both areas at once, it will blend that away. We're going to start adding the green for the grass now, and again, like the sky, it's darker in the back, and as it comes forward towards you, it will get lighter and lighter. Now I'm just flicking up the paint there to make it look like grass, so it's not a harsh edge or anything, and it just gives the impression of grass. We're just going to keep on working on that, bringing more lighter green as it comes forward. And again, I'm flicking that grass. I'm going to have grass all the way across here. A lot of that is going to be covered up with the jack-o'-lantern, but it's just easier just to get it all in there all at once. And it's good practice too, to where I can make it look more like grass that I like. And here comes a much lighter shade. And then we're gonna flick that up into the other paint as well. It'll just blend really nice. That dark line behind there with that light grass on top really will make it pop. Just get a little more here, flick that up also, it's just so funny how just such a little bitty thing makes such an impression. Now I'm going to get the bottom of this painting as well. Again, I like it to look nice all the way around. So if it's going to hang on a wall, it'll be good looking all the way around. If it's sitting on a shelf or whatever, I want it to look nice from all angles. Also, you want to be careful, okay, got it, why didn't,
Okay, so we're gonna start with our pumpkin. And I have on here some, oh, I forget the name of it, but it's a deep yellow. I'm gonna put it over here. I'm gonna add some orange to that. And I'm gonna add some white because this is transparent paint. There we go. Now I'm going to add my face so I know where not to paint. A round nose to me gives him a little friendlier face. I don't like things to be too ugly. I don't think that's gonna work. Let's see. Let's go this way. Okay, and then this way. And then we'll put the teeth in that way. There we go. That's better. Okay. All right, so now we know where to ignore. All righty, so I'm gonna put in, I'm coming in here with this background color. And all I'm doing down here is mixing in more paint. And you have to add that white for it to be opaque. I want to get all the way over to that black line, although it doesn't matter. There we go. I'm going to come up under here, up to the mouth. Now you could paint this on anything if you had a something from, you know, like a wooden thing that was the shape of a pumpkin. This is how you would give your pumpkin more reality looking to it. Okay, so we have different color, different shades in there. I'm just, again, just adding more. Wrong yellow. Okay, I'm going to come down in here. Now I'm going to let my brush do the work. I'm going to let it shape the pumpkin. This is the only one right here down the middle where it has, where it's kind of straight. The rest of them will all have a curve to them. Because it's mimicking the shape of the pumpkin. While I'm down here, I'm just using these two colors and some white. So don't think I'm mixing anything that you're not seeing. Now this brush has to go this way. Now you can see we have a lot of different colors going on there. It won't stay that way, okay? Now you see that little roll right there? We don't want that. If it dries like that, it will be impossible to move that around. Now I'm coming over here with some more of that dark orange and I'm gonna put it in. Now I'm blending these colors together now. Again, this is the one that would be straight, is the one down the middle. But even it could have some curve. Okay, I'm going to add another color to my palette. I should have thought about it to begin with, but you know, added some burnt sienna to my palette. Now I'm going to work over here in this edge and I'm going to mix that with that. You can't change this whole pile of paint unless you use a boatload of paint. Now this is the back side, so I want it to be darker. I Again, there's not enough white in that to make it the color that I want. I'm actually even going to add a little bit of the blue to that to darken it up even a little more. I might even take just a teeny weeny bit of black in there. Okay, see, I'm trying to darken this part back here. There we go. Okay, now I want that, I'm picking up a little more black. I'm gonna work it out here on the edge, and now I'm gonna pull some of this burnt sienna into that. I want back here to be even darker. This is where the stem sits. There. Okay, now we're gonna put in, using this dark color, we're gonna put in the ribs. Up on the point edge of that brush, bring it, pressure is really critical here, folks. They don't all come together. They come down, but they don't meet together at the bottom, okay? Now, this one might. I'm just gonna go straight on through because it's gonna get painted black in a few minutes. See, here's the center. So they're not meeting in the center, okay? Now, we're going to take some of that really dark that I mixed up over here, and I'm going to put it back in here. Well, that's still not dark enough. Picking up a little more black and putting it in there. There. And underneath here. And underneath there. Just a little shadow. Okay. Okay, I'm coming back with a smaller brush. Don't worry about any of this up here. We're going to fix all of this. Let me kind of smooth that out a little bit. A little too much paint right there. Okay, we're going to put the eye in here. Now I see I kind of goofed that up. You'll notice as you go along, you'll figure out, oh, well, I should have done this. Okay. There's the eye. Again, you don't want that little roll of paint there. You need to get that out of the way. I'm gonna add a little white to that mix so it doesn't show, so it's opaque, so the what's behind it doesn't show through. Add some burnt sienna to that. There we go. So you can change the shape of the eye with the black part. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Now, I've got these colors on my brush. I'm gonna pull over here in some black because I don't want solid black. Now I'm gonna add some of this purple to that. It will make it darker, but it will make it, I don't know, not quite so harsh. Okay, so we're gonna put in, again, I said you could paint this on any kind of a surface. If you had a plaque, you wanted to do it. You don't wanna play here too much in the paint. You want to put it on and let it go. I'm using my baby finger to steady my hand. I'm picking up some more of that dark paint. See how this is kind of goobered up there? When I can fix that just by going right over it. Just picking up this dark paint. You want to try to make as few strokes as possible. Always fun. And then we come down here with the mouth, and you can fix that mouth any way you want. not sure I'm happy with this. But we're gonna keep going. Adding a little more black and a little more of that purple to my paint so it's not so harsh. I never use black right out of the tube. I'm just gonna cover these all the way up. We can make teeth in a minute or two. Gonna give him a big grin there. Okay. All right, so now I'm gonna give him a bigger grin over here. There. Okay, I'm gonna rinse all that black out of my brush again, and we're gonna work on him. I might even go with that same brush I just had. Yeah, we're gonna work back in here. I'm gonna take some of this burnt sienna up here. I'm gonna add some white to it because it needs to have that opaqueness. Now I need more of the burnt sienna. I need some of that yellow. I need some of this black, some of this dark. And I'm even gonna put some orange in there. Okay, so let's work in here. Okay, now I'm gonna darken it up a little bit by adding some of that black, more of the burnt sienna out here on the edge. Like I said, you can't mix this whole pile up, but you can mix a small piece of it. Okay, so over here, these are just duller. Okay, they're duller back here because they're farther away. I'm not going to cover up all that black that I put in there though. I'm going to keep that. There we go. Okay, so I think I like how that looks. Okay, so now I think I'm going to come back here with some more orange and some more white. And I'm gonna kind of refresh these guys. Oh yeah. Let all that paint that's on your brush soak through there. I'm even kind of covering up those ribs. That's kind of burying them down inside of there. Now we can come back and darken those up. You can play around with this for quite a while. Until you're happy with it. This is your painting and you need to be happy with it. Oh, we didn't do our nose, did we? We need to come back and get our nose. We're gonna put some highlights on this in a minute and you're gonna be amazed at what that does. You paint the whole painting and then you put some highlights and some shadows in the right places. And things just kind of go crazy. It's like, oh my gosh, look how that looks. Adding a little more white to my orange to cover up, to make it opaque. Letting the brush do the work of shaping the pumpkin. Okay. Now, I'm going to come back with this dark color, but I didn't clean my brush, so it's not as dark as it was. I'm going to be right up here on the point edge of that brush and put this back in there. I'm going to add a little black to that. I'm going to pick up some of this black and put it over here. There. You just use just a tiny bit of the black. Light pressure all the way down. Keep reminding yourself, I have to. Light pressure, all the way down. There you go. Coming back over here. Light pressure. There we go. We're going to come back in the middle. We're going to put up a black nose in there, but we need that, kind of need that stripe. And I'm still not happy with what I have going on back here. It's too solid color. That helped just that one little bit. Oh, and I'm going to pick up some yellow. I'm going to work it over here. I rinsed my brush out, but I didn't clean it completely. And I'm going to add this deep yellow to it. Okay, so we're going to say the light's coming from here. So we need some highlight here and here and maybe even back in here and back over there and some here in the front. Yeah. Okay, this side over here is not going to get any, just maybe a few too much. There we go. If you get too much, wipe it off. You got fingers. Okay, so we're letting this black in here dry. We're going to come back and put some light in there. But I'm picking up a small bristle brush, and I'm bringing the burnt sienna over here, adding a little bit of white to it, adding some of the blue, darkening it up. I'm just going to pull off some of this black that's here and put it right in there. Go back with some more of the burnt sienna. We're going to paint the stem. So the stem is right in here. And he's wider at the bottom and he gets narrower at the top. Okay. There we go. It's pretty good. Okay, he's looking pretty good. I'm bringing my bristle brush back. I'm going to come back in here in this paint. Add a touch of white to that. And then I want to wipe most of the paint off. I want to come in here to the eye like there's a candle in here. I'm just barely going to touch and pull, touch and pull, touch and pull. So there's some light in there. Same thing over here. Touch and pull. Touch and pull. Touch and pull. No, very little pressure though. We may do this several times. The light's going to be a lot darker over on each side and brighter in the middle. Okay, so now we have some teeth here, but we're putting the light in between the teeth. So there's a tooth and there's a tooth. Right there's a tooth. And right here. Right there's a tooth. I'm going to come out here in the corner and we're going to put a tooth right in there. There. Now we can come back and kind of make those teeth a little more definite, like right here, right here, right here. We could put one over here. If we put one over here, we're going to have to add, excuse me, we're going to have to add some more light to actually see that tooth. So I'm just picking up some more of that deep yellow, a little bit of white, maybe some of the regular yellow. And then I'm wiping most of the paint off. I'm going to come around this tooth. Oh, yeah. Yep. Put that in between there. Very light pressure. There we go. I'm standing back. You know, a painting is meant to be viewed at 6 feet. Okay, so I like that lighter color. I'm going to pick up some of that and put it in the eyes. Now here I'm just gonna blend it away with my finger. I don't want it to be too harsh. There we go. Okay, he's looking pretty good to me. Okay, so now I'm coming back with my burnt sienna. And a little bit of, a teeny bit of white, some blue. I want to darken this up. And I'm gonna go over that stem again. Not dark enough. I'm gonna pick up a little bit of the black. If you don't have varying colors, then it's hard to tell what you're looking at. Okay. That's not bad. I would like it to be a little darker. I'm adding some more of that dark right in there. Okay, so now what I'm going to do on the end here, I'm going to add some of the light color right on the end to where you're looking at the end of that stem. Okay, so now I've still got my bristle brush. I'm going to put some warts on this. I'm going to just tap, lightly tap, and then up again in here. There. I'm still not happy with that color right in here. It's just not dark enough. I think it'll be dark enough this time. Yep, there we go. I will come back. And now we're going to put some more warts back on that. I'm using that deep yellow. Just tapping. Okay. I stand back and I look and see what I don't like. Well, what I don't like is this part right in here. It needs, like, this is the lip where the, oh, that makes a big difference. Where you cut out the top and you pulled out all the guts. There. Okay, so that makes it look much better. Now I'm adding some more burnt sienna to my little black mixture thing going on over here. And I'm going to, yep, there we go. I'm going to just sort of pull this in. Picking up a little more of the burnt sienna. I don't want it too dark. There we go. Okay, I like what we got there. Now we're going to come back in here with our yellow, our deep yellow. We're over here, we're adding some white to that. And we're going to come back in here and highlight this again. When acrylic paint dries, the water evaporates out of it and it gets darker always. So since these are going to be lighter, I'm going to put this over here and rub it mostly off. I'm going to come back in here with my grass. I'm going to take this blue, pull it over here, add some white to it, and add some yellow. More blue, and maybe even some of that deep yellow. Trying to get an interesting color of green. That's looked pretty good. Now what I want to do is I want to come down in here, and now I want to just flip it up on the, like the pumpkin sitting in the grass. I'm going to add some more regular yellow to that, so it's a little lighter. I want it sitting in that grass. More white even. Down in here. Right across. And then you flick it up into what's there. You just touch it and flick it up. Okay, so now he's sitting down there in the grass. It's got a straight line there, and I don't like that. Just drug my shirt in the yellow paint. There we go. Okay, so now I'm just going to bring some stems up here like this. I'm going to come and get some darker green over here. And now I'm coming back for that lighter color, adding a little more white and a little more yellow in there. You want them going in different directions. You don't want them all, see how they're all going this way? So now we've got to add something this way to give it a little more interest. Like he's sitting out there in a field. I can come back, I'm going to rinse that off. And I'm going to pick up some of this, of the deep yellow and some of the white. And I'm just going to come in here, touch and flick. Touch and flick, like seed pods, okay? And I can do it anywhere. I can do it even in a place where there is no stem. There, okay? He's looking pretty good. Everything but the mouth to me. The mouth is not looking good yet. So, everything looks good to me but the mouth. So I have cleaned off my bristle brush. I am coming over here with some of this yellow, and I'm going to do some more. I'm going to shape those teeth a little better. Add a little more white to that. It's just not opaque enough. This is a real learning curve here, making it, oh yeah. Practicing enough to get it where you want it. Now let's come back over here and add some more of that really bright color in between those teeth. Let's get some on that side. There we go. Okay, I'm liking what I'm seeing here. I'm going to bring some of this lighter color up into here too. Like there's a candle in the pumpkin. There we go. Okay. So we have a jack-o'-lantern here, and I'm pretty happy with it. I might work on his mouth some more. You might work on his mouth some more. It just depends on what you like, what you don't like. I think that the handle, I always call it a handle. It's really a stem. It's not got enough color to it. I'm picking up some of that deep yellow and white. And I'm gonna tap some more warts in there. Very light out here on the edge. It can be bigger down here, but out here on the edge, it's very light pressure. Okay? Oh yeah, I like the way that looks. I might even put a little bit of that, oh, yeah, right in there. Okay, so he's starting to look pretty jazzy. But anytime you're painting a pumpkin for, you know, on a plaque or anything for your decorations, this is how you would do it to give it a 3D look, to where it wasn't just so flat looking. Okay? So thank you so much. Have a great day. Let's paint together soon. Real soon. Okay, I promised to show you some of the crafty things I made using this same process. This is nothing more than a block of wood that my husband had left over, probably as a 2x6. Okay, he had built something and there was this piece left over. So I just painted very quickly, very lightly. I didn't go to nearly this kind of degree. I just painted a pumpkin. And I thought, well, I've got some 2x4s. So I painted a white pumpkin on there. And this has lots and lots of rough places. I left them. I wanted this to look very primitive. And so then I have another one. So they sit on a shelf like this. And so I know I didn't spend 10 or 15 minutes on each one. And, you know, I painted the background first and all the way around. And then I painted the pumpkins on the front. There's no jack-o'-lantern, it's just a pumpkin. It's the very same process I used to do that, only not quite so fancy, not quite so nice. So I hope you enjoyed this, and thank you so much for being here. Means the world to me. Leave me a comment. Tell me how you're going to use this in your painting. Have a great day.